Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Well, for many children, summertime means going to camp, and whether it's sleepover camp or day camp, some kids have a tough time adjusting to the new camp environment. Joining us today to talk about how parents can help kids manage summer camp blues is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Claypo. Thank you so much, sir, for being here with us this morning.
Thank you, Brooke.
So we've all seen this, the kids that kind of cry a little bit when they have to go to sleepovers, or the kids getting on the bus crying, and maybe sometimes in my case, the parents
That's crying when the kids are going on.
Yeah. So what can we do to help this experience be more fun and less overwhelming for our babies?
Well, and that's the sad thing, right? Because camp's supposed to be a good thing, and when there's lots of tears and lots of fears, it sometimes is a traumatic thing. And what we do as parents on the front end can really mean, really have a big difference. And it's simple things.
Okay, so what do you mean by that? What can we do?
Well, I like to give kids a chance, if possible, to practice sleeping over. Because if you think about it, particularly with sleepover camp, a lot of times it's the longest time a child has ever been away, and it's usually the first time they've been away more than maybe one night or two nights. So if possible, give your child a chance, whether it's at relatives or friends, to sleep over three nights, maybe even four nights. I know that can get hard logistically, but if you can give your child some reference point of what it's like to be away for more than a night, then when they get there, they have something to go off of. So anything you can do to give your child practice beforehand can be extremely important.
And do you recommend maybe them taking a little reminder of home, like a comforter, like a maybe a favorite blanket, a toy to help them out?
Send them with whatever makes them most comfortable. But also, and that's a good point, prepare them for what they're about to experience. A lot of times as parents, we don't want to talk about homesickness because we're afraid if we tell them, then they'll get homesick, right? But the reality is most kids are going to get homesick. So I think it's real important to give your child an expectation that they may feel bad, that they may feel bad for a couple days, that that's normal, that it's okay, and that those feelings are going to go away. Because when they happen, that way the child's not caught off guard as much. You're not trying to scare your child, but you're trying to give them realistic expectations.
And what about tools to cope?
Simple things. One, give them a journal and let them write home. It's something that young kids don't always think about, but it allows them to be connected. Most important thing, though, tell them what their counselors are there for. Kids think their counselors are there to guide games and to police. They don't understand their counselors are there to help them with their feelings. So letting your child know that if they feel sad, that they can go to their counselor and talk about those things, because now you've given your child an adult who is an emotional attachment figure, and that's really important, and it's something that kids wouldn't normally think about.
And those counselors are oftentimes trained.
Oh, absolutely. So it's really giving your child permission to talk about the thing that is bothering the most with another adult.
All right. Well, Dr. Josh Claypo, thank you so much. And if you would like to watch this segment again and learn more, go to CBS42.com.